Well, hello friends! How is everybody doing? If you're playing online bingo with me today, this is the second make and take card that we are going to be making. So online bingo, we play four games of bingo online. I send you bingo cards in the mail along with an awesome kind of swag bag full of beautiful product from our occasions catalog. And you get your bingo cards in there so you can play along right online with me. And then we also do make and takes too. So if you're not already playing online bingo with me and are interested, watch for more details for future online bingo events at my blog at gatheringinkspiration.com. So, okay, in the meantime, let's go ahead and make this awesome card. It's another beauty. Oh, I love this flower. It is like just so gorgeous, and I love kind of the shading in it too, and I'm going to show you guys. It's actually a two-step stamp that we are using. It is from the Incredible Like You stamp set. So we used this stamp right here, and then kind of with that really pretty kind of pale pink shading behind it, we used that stamp right there. Little bit of watercolor look to the stamp set as well. We used this sentiment right here on our card, hope your day is as amazing as you. And then there are other great sentiments, so glad we are friends, incredibly proud of you, and I just adore you. And I love, because I don't feel like we have a lot of stamp sets with those two sentiments in them either. Here's another opportunity to kind of do some two-step stamping with some shading as well. So just a gorgeous stamp set. If you don't have this stamp set for the make and take for online bingo, just find another flower that's about that same size, and then a sentiment that will fit on your little strip of paper as well. So I think, you know, there are lots of flower stamps and lots of sentiments I'm sure that you have. So again, if you don't have that stamp set, you're going to be just fine, because that's one of the things with sending these little make and take packets. I cannot do the stamping for you. So okay, let's go ahead and get started. What do we want to do first? We're going to do our stamping, I think. Rewind. I'm going to tell you dimensions, because that's always handy to know that. Otherwise, sometimes I tend to forget to give you those if I get too far along in things. Okay, so I will tell you, this is a piece of our thick, very vanilla cardstock, the 8.5 by 11 cardstock. We made a tall card here, so we cut it in half along the 8.5 inch side at 4 1/4 inches right there, and then along the 11 inch side, we scored it in half at 5.5 inches, okay? Then we also, a couple of other pieces that you need to know dimensions on. This is some of the beautiful Floral Romance Designer Series paper, just beautiful, soft. Oh, it's so almost realistic, like that photorealistic kind of with that shading in it too. It's just gorgeous paper. So this piece of DSP measures 3 inches by 4 inches. And then we have a strip of very vanilla cardstock that measures 1 inch by 4.5 inches. Everything else, these are just scrap pieces of vanilla and Pear Pizzaz cardstock. I will give you all of the product codes and descriptions of everything in the details to the YouTube video, so that if you don't have this stamp set or designer series paper or the gorgeous variegated ribbon, you can get those ordered easily with those item codes. Okay, so all right, now we are ready to do our stamping. So I am going to grab, I love using my Stampin' Pierce mat when I am stamping with my photopolymer stamps. I think just needs a little bit of give sometimes underneath, because the foam, I guess, in the stamp, you know, like normally on our red rubber stamps. So this is kind of a good alternative to that. Okay, so I have my Petal Pink ink, and I am going to just do kind of a nice easy tap, tap, tap. I'm going to press straight down and straight up, and I'll have to tell you, I wasn't even sure that I needed the shading, but look at that. And then when you add that little, it just adds so much to it, doesn't it? And I have always stamped this one first and then the shading over top. You might get a different look. I haven't even tried it. I loved how this one looks, so I just kind of went with it. But you might get, like I said, a different look if you did the shading first and then the detail over top. Now we are going to use our Pear Pizzaz ink for our little stem for our flower, and we're gonna just kind of put that right about there. And then while we are at it, we might as well stamp You know what? Actually, let's punch first so we know where to stamp. So I've got my banner, triple punch, and I'm just going to slide this in. And I'm going to punch on one end. I'm going to slide it in again. It's maybe a titch wider than 1 inch, so it doesn't want to fit in those grooves perfectly. But I think I did a good job with my punching there. Okay, so now we know where to put our sentiment. So hope your day is as amazing as you. And if this doesn't turn out, we can always flip it over and stamp it on the other side. So you get two tries here. I think that worked just perfectly. Okay, so let's see. We are gonna do our die cutting now. I'm gonna make sure to not lose anything. I feel like oh my gosh, I already lost my Pear Pizzaz piece. But so these two, we need our Big Shot with our magnetic platform. Make sure I've got enough room there. Okay, the magnetic platform with one clear cutting pad underneath. And let's see, we're gonna lay those down on there. So we have our layering oval framelits are what we're using. I've already kind of cheated and put the two that I need back in here. So we're gonna put that one there and that one there. And I was gonna see, here's my kind of messy, right? Let's go from, we've got one, two, looks like the third largest straight edge. And then one looks like the second largest scallop edge. Okay, so third largest straight edge, second largest scallop edge in the oval collection framelits. This is actually going the wrong way. We want the ridges down so they make the cuts. I'm gonna flip that one there and that one there. That looks good. Okay, we need our other clear cutting pad on top. And we're cranking our handle. Okay, oh, this flower is just gorgeous. I don't know what it is about it. It's the shading for me, I think. Get that one. All right, so we're done with our Big Shot. We can scoot that guy out of the way. And we can start building our card now. So we're going to put some adhesive on the back of this oval. And we're going to add it to our scallop-edged oval. The Pear Pizzaz. Beauty, beauty, beauty. Oops. I think I'm a little off kilter today. Nothing's quite straight. We will add some dimensionals so that that piece is all ready to go when we are ready to put it on our card. Okay, now we're gonna add some adhesive on the back of our designer series paper. Ooh, I should have told you too, I'm gonna teach you guys how to make the perfect bow. We're gonna do that next. I love. So can you see, it's not super squinched tight in terms of the bow, the knot, I guess. Sometimes that's kind of what happens is people tend to make them a little bit too tight and they squinch up too much. So, and this you can do with any ribbon that you have. So you are going to start, I always leave the bolt on or the ribbon on the bolt to start with. You're going to take your right hand and with kind of that short working end, you're going to flip it kind of over so it's looks kind of like that breast cancer loop. Then with that short little working end, you're gonna put that in through that little hole. And I've kind of got my finger there too, just to kind of keep it open because we're gonna lay this down on here. We are gonna feed our ribbon. Make sure it's straight back there, right? Around there, and then we are going to cut it, okay? So I'm gonna grab my scissors. Scoot this guy out of the way. Now I like to kind of lay this down. So you can see this is the piece that I just cut and that was the loop that I was holding originally with my other index finger. I just want to put that piece. Now you can see this when I pull on it does not do anything. It's just that loop that came around from the back. This tail, that was that working end that I first put through the little hole. That's the one that tightens things up. And can you see how as I pull it, it makes kind of it's just not all squinched up super tight, I guess is the only way I can put it, that I love how that looks. And then I'm just gonna kind of scooch it around to get it over where I want it. We're gonna trim those down, but I'm gonna wait and do that a little bit later. So remember, the one end is just what you put through. You cannot make it tighter. It's only the other short working end that was through that little loop that you tighten up there. Okay, so, And this is the kind of bow that you have to practice. Watch this part of the video over and over again. I think I probably made a card with like, I don't know, 40 or 50 of those bows on them before I finally felt confident. Now I love to use that bow. Okay, so now I think we can kind of trim up our ribbon a little bit. That there and that there. And then we're gonna put some more dimensionals on the back of this little piece, our sentiment, right? Hope your day is as amazing as you. Wouldn't you love to get a card that said something like that, right? Awesome sentiment. Okay, so we're gonna put that just down at the bottom. And then to kind of finish things off, where are my pearls? They're right here. Okay, perfect. And I'm gonna use, I forgot my take your pick tool, so I'm gonna just use my paper snips. Are a great alternative, except when you do things like that, but it's actually almost easier sometimes if you flip it over, because then you can then you can find that glue dot. I'm no expert in this. I'm a lot better when I'm not videoing, though, I'll tell you that. I can do this super fast when I'm not on video, but there we go. Yeah, like I said, it's almost better if you flip it over, because then you can kind of get to that glue dot. That's all we're really trying to do. Oh, it didn't flip though. There we go. Flip and grab. Okay, now I'm just gonna put three more little baby pearls kind of right in a row. This is when I miss those strips of pearls that we used to have. The take your pick tool would probably be much more helpful at this point. But we're almost there. We're gonna get one more pearl on our card. Sorry. There we go. Flipped. It's like a turtle on its back, right? There, and put that one right there. There we go. Okay, so what do you guys think? Isn't that just a gorgeous card? I love this variegated ribbon, is so pretty. And then the pearls add a nice little kind of soft, dainty touch to it. And then that beautiful designer series paper along with that awesome flower. So thank you so much. I hope if you're playing online bingo, you've been enjoying that tonight. And I hope you enjoyed this card as your make and take as well. Make sure you check out my blog for future stamping events and opportunities at gatheringinspiration.com. And then as well, if you're ready to shop, make sure you grab the host code that's on the right-hand side toolbar of my blog to when you shop online at amysuzanne.stampinup.net. Use that host code. I always send you a free embellishment with at least a $50 order. And then, of course, it's celebration right now, too, so you always get that free celebration item as well. So lots of good free stuff with your orders. So thanks so much for watching. I hope you guys were inspired. I hope you have a great day, and we'll see you soon. Bye, everybody.